Pensioner Joan Parr lives in a tiny one-bedroom flat on the 16th floor of a tower block in Acton. Over the last year, the rent she pays Ealing Council has almost doubled, and she's just about to lose the small amount of housing benefit she was entitled to. She says soaring rents are eroding her quality of life.
It is a way that we have to cut down on anything. You see, you look for it, you look for the cheaper type of food because you haven't got the money to spend. And you notice that your shoes go right down, you know, the heels go right down because it costs a terrific amount to have shoes repaired.
Ealing's Conservative Council claim mismanagement by previous Labour administrations has forced them to put rents up.
And we inherited a financial strategy from the previous Labour administration, which would have meant the housing revenue account didn't balance. They went for a higher risk strategy based on a legal loophole, which the government closed. We had no choice.
A damning report by the National Consumer Council puts Ealing at the top of a list of councils where rents have risen three times above government estimates. Rents in the borough are up 103%. In Conservative Hillingdon, they've increased by 48%, and Liberal Democrat Richmond, there's been a 36% rise. The NCC says the government must urgently change its housing policy.
Yes, we think at the moment the guidelines are fatally flawed. We're not arguing that the strategy of orientating the council sector towards more market rents is necessarily wrong, but that the government really does have to help poorer council tenants in a way in which the burden of that is carried by all taxpayers.
We're not prepared to change that system. If we did, it would allow councils like Lambeth, who are inefficient at collecting rent, who leave properties empty, to conceal that failure at the cost of putting up the community charge, and we simply can't allow that to happen.
Next month, two Ealing tenants will challenge the legality of the council's rent rises in the High Court. Jane Ball, Thames News.